Once you're all configured for performance, you'll want to monitor your performance so you can make adjustments and tune as needed. Azure SQL gives us a lot of opportunities to do this. Bob, can you tell us a little bit more about that?
Yeah, thanks, Anna. Just like SQL Server, you're going to see some familiar things show up in the monitoring story for Azure SQL. But if you remember back in an early video, we talked about the Azure ecosystem. This is an integration of resources like Azure SQL into the overall Azure infrastructure. So things like Azure Monitor, metrics, alerts, and logs are going to be available to you to look at things that are specific with some SQL type performance information. We'll see some examples of that in demos that we're going to do. But things like dynamic management views, DMVs, extended events, that's sort of like really core things people love about SQL Server. You're going to get access to that stuff, and we're going to talk in more details in a second. Lightweight query profiling, a great new feature in SQL 19 on by default in Azure SQL Database and MI, allowing you to get great information with live query plans against your Azure SQL deployment. And they're used to doing things like query plan debugging with things like set statements, like set statistics time on or set statistics IO on or even set show plan on. All that stuff's there for you because the T-SQL language is almost identical running in Azure SQL. Now, query stores on by default. Query stores on by default, giving you such powerful capabilities, just like you have in SQL Server. But what you're going to see later on in this module is because we're going to use the query store behind the scenes, we're going to light up some visualizations in the Azure portal and even some intelligent performance capabilities to give you deeper insights.
Now, you know, Bob, this is great. And, you know, throughout this workshop, we've kind of had this fun dynamic of, you know, you being what I call hyper-focused or thorough. And so, you know, when we were looking at this, I know you dove into some of the DMVs and extended events that are available. Can you kind of share with us what you learned and what you found?
Yeah, Anna, hyper-focused, that's a very nice thing to you to say about me, about my thoroughness. Well, you know, honestly, the truth is that as I'm assessing SQL Server and Azure SQL, DMVs have been such an part of the history of the product since way back to 2005, SQL 2005. It's really important to kind of know, like, what is possible for you for Azure SQL like a SQL Server? So first of all, for Azure SQL Managed Instance, you get everything. Every DMV you're used to doing, you get it. Plus, in addition, we have some new DMVs like server resource stats, which is going to allow you to look at almost like some perfmon capabilities at overall usage of your managed instance. For Azure Database, most common SQL Server DMVs available. In fact, with the V12 architecture we did, we kind of lit up a lot of SQL surface area DMVs you didn't have access to before. Not everything is as you have in MI is there for an Azure SQL database, but I would say for my assessment, the ones you really true and need, you're going to find are there for you. In addition, DMDB resource stats and Elastic Pool resource stats are also going to give you some kind of like resource usage capabilities, kind of from a polling snapshot point of view, that's really important to kind of monitor the overall resource usage of your Azure SQL database deployment. Now, let's dive a little bit deeper. Things like DMIO virtual file stats, that's pretty important. In fact, that's going to be one of the key elements for you to look at IO latencies in your MI and database deployments. But even DMO's performance counters for the SQL performance counters are available to you both in MI and database for you to look at. And then DM user DB resource governance, that's an interesting one. We're going to look at that later in a demonstration. That's going to give you some information about the configuration of the governance or limits of your Azure SQL database or MI deployment. Now, being hyper-focused, of course, I like to geek out. So if you really want to do some nitty-gritty type dive into what's going on, things like user DB resource governor internal or even these other resource governor DMVs give you a lot of details behind the scenes about how we are configuring and governing and putting limits or allowing the execution of resources against your Azure SQL database or MI deployment. So that's DMVs. You're going to find a lot of the stuff you know and love in SQL Server is all available for you, both with MI and Azure Database, and then some additional ones to help you monitor your deployments. Now, what about X-Event or extended events? So first of all, for Azure SQL Database, most of the common events and actions you're used to are going to be available to you. You just want to trace SQL queries, you get access to those kind of type things. You want to do common actions with that, add in, as you know, orthogonal information to the event itself, like SQL text or whatever it is, that's available for you. From a target point of view, you're going to get file targets just like you know and love in SQL Server, except because you don't have access to the file system, you're going to use Azure Blob Storage to store your extended event file targets. You're going to get ring buffer and counter targets in addition to file targets. Now, when it comes to Azure SQL Managed Instance, all events, all targets, all actions used in SQL Server are all supported. Just like an Azure database, that file target is going to be redirected to an Azure Blob storage that you can read later through Management Studio or through system functions. And then Azure MI is going to support all the events you're used to in SQL Server, but even a few specific events that are targeted to the Azure MI deployment.
Thanks, Bob. You know, we've learned about some of these various options from Azure Monitor to defaults like Query Store and LQP that are there to help you out. We also geeked out a little bit on DMVs and some of the X events specifics related to Azure SQL Database and Azure SQL Managed Instance. See you in the next video.